It is not what you say. It's how you say it. You can have brilliant ideas, but if you don't get your message across, your ideas will take you nowhere. How many times we say something with the intention of provoking a certain reaction in people, but they receive our message and react in a completely different way from what we expected? What happened there? Many people would say something like that. No matter how much I try, they don't understand me, so I'll give up. Or something like, they are not listening, they are not willing to collaborate, so I had enough. Which can be true. However, what is twisted here is, if this is happening, if that happened to you, I have not so good news, because it is your problem, not theirs. Hi, I'm Trilia Lopez, communication architect, and for the past decade, I've been helping professionals like you to break barriers and build bridges by developing effective communication skills. Every time you are in front of people, you have the opportunity to change their perception of the world. You have the opportunity to influence them to think differently. In fact, in most cases, we want them to follow our ideas, to agree with us, to trust us. However, it's our job to make them to understand us. And if it's not happening, don't blame them, the audience. Instead, you have some work to do. In every talk, every presentation, every conversation, knowing your topic, showing your competence is important, of course. However, what comes first is your audience. You need, you must, you ought to know your audience as much as you can in order to be able to communicate with them in a language they can understand. There is no such a thing as one size fits all in communication. We need to adapt our topic to our audience, our words to our audience, our examples to our audience. It is quite challenging, especially in this globalized world we live in, especially if we truly want to bring diversity and inclusion to the workplace. It is our job as leaders in our community, in our company, to understand our audience's language, to understand their ways of communication, their perception and perspective of the world, so we make sure they will understand us. As Stephen Covey, the author of 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, stated very wisely, seek first to understand, then to be understood. We need to become better listeners. We need to open our senses to what is around us. However, a big challenge on that is the fact that most people listen to respond, not really to understand. It's important to stop being reactive and become proactive in our way of communicating. Every company, every employee, every person who truly wants to succeed in this new era need to be attentive to that. Saying something and expecting your audience to figure it out won't lead anywhere. Or worse, it might lead to misunderstandings that can have serious consequences. And if you are a leader, you have to make sure your team understands you. But first, you need to get to know them. And if you want to have a diverse team in an inclusive environment, you all need to be able to listen, to understand, then to be understood. The pandemic added another challenge to all of us, the virtual space we are in. Most of us are still learning how to engage, interact, motivate, and bring value to the other side of the screen. Therefore, knowing your audience became even more challenging, as in most cases, we can read the person's body language and gestures through the screen. And as you know, the nonverbal communication signs are crucial for an effective communication. Because communication starts from your presence. First impressions matter. We all have heard the saying, you don't have a second chance to create a first good impression. And it's true. Therefore, self-awareness is key for effective communication. You need to know your strengths and value them, and be also aware of the areas you need to improve and work on them. You need to make sure that the way you think you come across is the way your audience is receiving and perceiving you. With every professional I work with, we spend more time discovering themselves, their presence, enhancing their self-awareness of how people perceive them, so they can make the changes necessary in order to create the impact they want to create, to align their intention with the impact they create. It's not about acting, it's about finding your most authentic voice and live by it. And presence is a core element of charisma. Every charismatic person is present, is a good listener. You can't be a good listener if you are not present in the moment. And presence is about first impressions. It's about your posture, your smile. It's about how you walk. It's about you being fully alignment with yourself. It's about you walking your talk. Presence is about aligning your verbal and nonverbal communication. In order to be fully present, the various elements of self, emotions, thoughts, physical and facial expressions, behaviors, must be in harmony, in alignment. Presence is about believing in your own story. And by doing so, your message is perceived as honest and authentic. When we experience conflict between our beliefs and our feelings, we are removed from the moment, so we can't be present. When we become inauthentic, our verbal and nonverbal behaviors begin to misalign. And when that happens, we not only feel uncomfortable, consciously or not, but also do so the people listening and looking at us. It's when people feel like, something is not right there. And when that happens, connection is broken. Therefore, you cannot build trust. The less present we are, the more poorly we perform. In this virtual world we are, being present adds an extra challenge. We are distant physically from each other and can be easily distracted from all the actions happening in the background of our screens. I urge you to be present, whether in person or virtually. First impressions matter. And if you are in a leading position, if you want to succeed in your career or business, you need to be present. You need to be able to listen to understand. Only then you will be able to craft a message which is clear and relevant to the audience you are speaking to. And only then, when they feel understood and listened to, you will be able to create the impact you want to create. You will be able to influence them. What can you do then? Here are my three very effective actions you can implement right now and start seeing changes. Number one, communication is not only about words, expressions, communication transcends words. It comes from within. You must believe on what you want to say. So your body, your voice, your gestures, we respond accordingly, in harmony, in alignment. Ask yourself, am I walking my talk? Number two, know your audience. I cannot say that more. This is crucial. Know everything you can possibly know about them. So you can bring examples, stories, anecdotes to your topic, to your presentation, to your conversation that they can relate to, that are relevant to them. That will break barriers and build bridges. Ask yourself, am I really listening or am I just waiting for my turn to speak? Number three, make sure your message is clear to your particular audience and then give. Focus on your message. It's not about you. It's not about how much you know. It's about them and how much they will benefit from what you say. You are only the vessel of the message you want to share. Focus on the message, and I guarantee you that you will come across with more credibility and charisma. Ask yourself, am I speaking from my heart or is my ego leading the show? To persuade, to influence, to inspire people to change, you first need to believe in what you say. Then you have to understand the audience perspective of the world so you can communicate with them from that place, using the language they can understand. Remember, it's not what you say, it's how and to whom.